Greetings, our Hebrew Israelite brothers and sisters. This is L.D. Smith, your watchman on the wall.
And my name is V.C.E. Smith, and I am the rib of the watchman.
Sons and daughters of Zion, this is our midweek teaching. Grab that King James.
All right. All right, class. Tonight's going to be a good teaching, Israel.
Mm-hmm.
The Father has given us, of course, it's a teaching about Levi because we are sent to the house of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a blessing in it tonight that it's also going to be talking about one of the other tribes.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to get a little understanding about some of the different tribes and with this one particular one and some of the things that were done
mm-hmm.
and how things were done back in the day when we were a people. It's a really good lesson, and mm-hmm. we hope that you get your Bible and read along with us so that you can get a full understanding of everything that we're going to show you mm-hmm. tonight.
Now, my brothers and sisters, as we always say here at LadaMinimo.org, we want you to think about the reading.
Mm-hmm.
Think about what you're reading, and then listen to it. Listen to it, and we know that the Most High will give you a clear understanding.
Mm-hmm.
Now, going forward, the rib, she's going to be coming out of Judges, the 17th chapter.
All right, we're going to start at verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a man in Mount Ephraim whose name was Micah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is Micah, a man. This is not a family member.
Right.
He's not a part of the 12 tribes.
Mm-hmm.
He is not a part of Israel. He's not the prophet back in the later books. This is another person.
This is another person.
Verse 2. And he said unto his mother,
mm-hmm.
the 1,100 shekels of silver that were taken from thee, somebody stole it from her, mm-hmm. about which thou cursest and speaketh of also in mine ear. So she was telling him all the time,
mm-hmm.
behold, the silver is with me.
Mm-hmm. Now look what
he said. I took it.
See that? The son took it from his mother.
He took it. And the mother said, blessed be thou of the Lord my son. So
mm-hmm.
in other words, she was glad it wasn't stolen and never be found again.
Because mm-hmm.
that was a lot of money. She was putting this away. You'll find out she was putting this away for him anyway. But
mm-hmm.
he stole it from his mother.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 3. And when he had restored the 1,100 shekels of silver to his mother said, I had wholly dedicated the silver unto the Lord from my hand for my son.
Mm-hmm.
So she already dedicated this money
already,
for him. It was going to be his anyway.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
To
make a graven image
mm-hmm.
and a molten image.
Mm-hmm.
Now, therefore, I will restore it unto thee. So that
mm-hmm.
means she gonna give him the money back, but she gonna take a portion to
mm-hmm.
do this thing
mm-hmm.
that she wanted to do for her son.
That's right.
All right, let's keep on going. We're on verse
mm-hmm.
4. Yet he restored the money unto his mother, and his mother took 200 shekels of silver
mm-hmm.
and gave them to the founder.
Mm-hmm.
That is the person that was the sculptor, the molder,
mm-hmm.
the person that made these images. Who made thereof a graven image and a molten image.
Uh-huh.
And they were in the house of Micah.
All right. Y'all see where we're going, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
They were already in the house, okay?
Let's keep
going. Verse 5. And the man Micah had an house of gods.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Gods are us at Micah's.
Yeah.
And made an ephod
uh-huh.
and a tephorim
mm-hmm.
and consecrated one of his sons
mm-hmm.
who became his priest.
His priest.
Did you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
So these two items that this Micah had in his house was something of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
But he needed a priest, so he made one of his sons
a priest
mm-hmm. to be able to use these things.
Mm-hmm.
You getting me? You see where we're going?
Mm-hmm.
All right. It says, in those days, there was no king in Israel. There was no governing over Israel
mm-hmm.
by kings during this time.
That's right.
So everybody was doing their own thing.
Everybody
all right?
their own thing.
But every man did that which was right in his own eyes.
All right. Pretty much like today.
Just like today.
Just like today.
You make up a God, you choose a God, you pick a God, you say you don't want a God.
Yeah.
Every man was doing what everybody wanted to do. All right, verse 7. And there was a young man out of Bethlehem, Judah. Of the family of Judah, who was a Levite.
Now you need
to
stop.
Now we got to explain this to you.
You got to explain this right now. See, because they don't understand.
They don't understand the writings of the Most High God, but we're going to explain this to you tonight. Sure. This young man was a Levite that sojourned around.
That's right.
He wound up in Bethlehem, Judah, living with this family of Judah.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
He was a Levite, though.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're going to find out, everybody wants a priest.
That's right.
So he was living there at this family. That family was blessed.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to keep on going.
Keep on.
All he said, and he sojourned there. That meant he left where he was, and he wound up in Bethlehem, Judah, and lived with some Judites. So
that's
he was
right.
of Judah, meaning
that
where he was living at. That's where
right.
he was dwelling at. All right. Verse 8.
All right.
And the man departed out of the city of Bethlehem, Judah, to sojourn where he could find a place. So he was done serving there.
Right.
He didn't want to stay there anymore. So this priest of the Most High God went out to sojourn and find him somebody else to stay with. All right. And he came to Mount Ephraim to the house of Micah.
All right.
Now Micah's not a Hebrew Israelite.
Sure.
Micah had nothing to do with the family. But check this out. As he sojourned. And Micah said unto him, whence comest thou?
Where you going?
Huh? Where you coming from? You a priest. He recognized him right on the spot.
Right on the spot.
Huh? A priest of the living God.
Ain't gotta say nothing.
He had to do nothing. He noticed him right off the spot. He said, and he said unto him, I am a Levite of Bethlehem Judah. I'm just coming from Bethlehem, Judah. And I go to sojourn where I may find a place. So now I'm out looking for some place to go. He done gave him all the information. Now he's getting ready to get good. All
right.
Verse 10. And Micah said unto him, dwell with me. And be unto me a father and a priest.
And a priest.
And I will give thee 10 shekels of silver by year. Every year I'm going to give you 10 shekels of silver and a suit of apparel. Every year you get a brand new fine robe apparel and thy vestures. I'm going to feed you every single day. So the Levite went in.
See, that's the good thing about being a priest. See, back in the biblical days, when you was a priest, you were well respected.
You was wanted by everybody.
I mean, everybody wanted you because guess what? Wherever you went, the blessing was there.
They listened to the priest, honey.
They knew that any time they needed anything, they needed for nothing because the Most High was going to be their supply.
That's right. Verse 11.
Let's keep on going.
And the Levite was content to dwell with the man. Found me a place. He gonna give me a new suit every year. He gonna feed me every day and pay me silver and then give me a roof over my head. He was happy.
Now you notice now he did say the man.
The man. He never said family.
His brother or nothing.
Brother.
His brethren. He said the man.
And nothing. All these is black folks, so that y'all know.
Yep.
Huh? The priest is black. Micah's black. His mama black. Everybody is black. All right.
Now let's keep on going.
And the young man became his priest and was in the house of Micah, meaning he dwelt where Micah probably owned properties and places and stuff, but he gave this priest a place to stay. So he was in his house.
Yep.
So that's just like if he came to the Smiths, he would be in a room. He would have his own separate place in the Smith house.
That's right.
All right. Verse 12. And Micah consecrated the Levite. And the young man became his priest and was in the house of Micah. And then said Micah, now know I that the Lord will do me good.
See that?
Hot dog.
He knew if I got the man of God, I ain't got to worry about nothing. God gonna take care of me.
Now I know.
God's gonna take care of me.
God got this thing. See, I have a what?
Hmm?
Levite to my priest.
To my priest. Right there in the pages. Right there in the pages.
All right.
See, you can't be blessed unless the man of God is there.
Got to have a priest.
You got to have a man of God.
Now, one time did Micah say, I pray all the time to God.
Not one time.
He answered my prayers. No, he didn't.
Not one time.
He saw that priest and said, ooh.
He said, no, no.
Now.
I got the priest.
I'll be blessed.
I got the priest now.
We're going to show you on down in here about Dan, too.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Let's keep on going.
This is chapter 18.
18. Mm-hmm.
In those days, there was no king in Israel.
They keep on, the writer keep on stressing.
Letting you know.
Ain't no king.
Every man was for himself. Everybody was doing
no
their own thing.
Everybody doing their own thing. Now let's keep on going here.
And in those days, the tribe of the Danites sought them an inheritance to dwell in.
Look for them a place.
So back when the land was divvied out, there were more Danites than they could hold the land. Mm-hmm. So these Danites was out looking for them an inheritance
right.
to get. He's going to tell you. He says, for unto that day, all their inheritance had not fallen unto them among the tribes of Israel. Now, y'all know the Most High taught y'all that when Levi went around taking all these different people's land, all 12 of them got land. It was supposed to be lands that they could dwell on, but some of the tribes were larger than other tribes.
Exactly.
So these people didn't get enough space for all them to live in, so they were going around different places trying to find a place to go to take as their land.
And notice the latter part of that sentence, it says, among the tribes of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
See, so we see again that there are many nations.
Many nations of Israel.
There are 12 different nations.
He didn't say under the tribe, the nation of Israel.
He says that. He says here, among the tribes of Israel.
And then they couldn't go live with just anybody. They had to have their own space because there wasn't no such thing as mixing up everybody.
That's right.
All right.
Let's keep on going.
Okay, verse 2. Is that right?
That's right.
And the children of Dan sent of their family.
See that? Their family. See?
Their family.
Their family. Not Simeon, huh? Not Reuben, huh?
Not but Issachar.
Their families.
Their so family.
But they do. They all have different families.
They all have
so
different families.
So how can they be the nation of Israel?
They're not one family. They're all from one son.
Virtually impossible.
Which, Isaac, but they're not all one family. They're their family of their father's house.
Jacob.
Okay? Okay. All right. Jacob. Okay. Let's go on here. Mm-hmm. So it says, 5 men from their coast, men of valor. So they sent the best they had.
Right.
They sent the Navy SEALs.
Yeah.
All right. From Zora and from Ishtuol to spy out the land and to search it. And they said unto them, go, search the land. Who, when they came to Mount Ephraim, to the house of Micah, they lodged there.
Now, y'all see now here, they're out on a search mission.
And they're on the outskirts.
They're going on.
Micah lived on the outskirts.
They're looking for some land to inherit. Now, y'all pay close attention what is finna take place now. Watch this right here.
Now, they getting ready to go lodge at Micah's because Micah got a lot of property. Micah got houses and places they could go and lodge in. But check this out. Verse 3. When they were by the house of Micah, say by. Not inside.
Right.
They were by the house of Micah. They knew the voice of the young man, the Levite.
See that? That's why we know that ain't nobody saying what we're saying here.
Nobody. Nobody.
I mean, countless people have came back and say, ain't nobody saying what y'all saying.
That's right.
See, the true people of the Most High who he have put in charge, they talk a whole different language.
Altogether different.
See, we are different. Not that we are just saying that we're different. Everybody knows that we're different. That's why they come against us.
Now, check this out. It didn't say, and they laid out eyes upon the Levite.
Never saw him. Huh? Never
they
saw him.
They knew because the way he had that beard hanging down.
Never
on
saw
the
him. Never saw him.
Huh? They knew never that robe him. That he had on.
Heard his voice.
They said they heard.
Heard his voice.
His voice.
Hmm? Ain't that something?
Huh? They heard that voice of that young man, the Levite.
Mm-hmm.
And they turned.
Hither.
Huh? What the heck? A priest! A priest is here, y'all!
They heard that voice. They, what?
What?
What did I hear?
Oh, they turned hither.
That's the voice
with
of the Levite.
With a struck though.
That's right. That's right.
It said, and said unto him, who brought thee hither?
Uh-huh.
They got excited because their plan was to go in and take the land.
That's right.
And they thought God had placed them a Levite there to give them instructions. You're going to find out. What they got excited when they found it. This is God got to be doing this. Check this out. And they turned hither and said unto him, who brought thee hither? And what maketh thou in this place?
Uh-huh.
Huh? This ain't no tribal Levite house. This ain't no Hebrew Israelites.
Right. Uh-huh.
What you doing here? And what hast thou here?
Yeah. What you doing
what,
here?
What, I mean, what is the reason for you to be
you
in this man's house?
Here.
You are a priest. Verse 4.
What's on here now?
And he said unto them, thus and thus, meaning, went like this. Went like, hey, you gonna pay me? Give me money. He just said, dealeth Micah with me, and hath hired me, and I am his priest.
His priest. Look at
all right
that.
Now,
look at that.
Huh? Verse 5.
Keep on cooking.
And they said unto him, ask counsel.
We're
not talking to each other.
Uh-huh.
We pray
thee.
We pray
thee,
you priest,
huh?
Of God.
Mm-hmm.
What that we may know whether our way which we go shall be prosperous.
I guess that
sealed that deal.
That stopped that about I pray.
That sealed that deal.
Huh?
They found this. They was already on that journey.
Sure
they
was.
Already out to do the deed, and then they saw a priest, and they said, "Ho."
Let's get some reassurance.
We'll know for a fact.
Let's get some reassurance.
This is what we supposed to. They didn't say they prayed before they went out.
No, they didn't.
They got together and everybody prayed.
No, they didn't.
They mouthed up before the Most High God.
And these here are the Most High's children.
These are the Danites.
Look what he says.
Verse 7, he says, then the five men
Six.
And the priest said unto them, go in peace, before the Lord is your way wherein ye go.
So wherever you go.
He said, I done took care
God
of it.
God is going to be there.
Did he say that the priest got down and started praying out and crying out?
He said, go. Go where you want to go. Wherever you're going. God's gonna be there. See that? But the whole point that we're stressing there, you know, individual how about well I can pray and
you
I can
can't
pray. No, you can't.
Israel got
right
no word getting to God. God said
it's
I don't
right
hear
the
you.
These here Gadites did not pray to God. They went to the priest and they told the priest, you'll pray to God for us. And see is it okay for us to go ahead and venture on.
Then we know we're doing the right thing.
Once the priest told them that, they went on and take care of some business.
That's right.
Now let's keep on going.
Verse 7. Then the five men departed.
See that?
And came to Lycia, whatever.
These the spies.
And saw the people that were therein.
Mm-hmm.
How they dwelt carelessly.
Uh-huh.
You know how it was.
Yeah.
Free love. They was happy. Everybody
doing their own thing.
Peace. All this peace. After the manner of the Zidoians or somebody says quiet and secure.
See that?
Mm-hmm. Huh? Happy and peaceful living in Zionsville.
As you say, happy go lucky
folks.
Yeah.
And there was no magistrate in the land. Huh? They didn't have no police,
no law,
no sheriffs, no state troopers,
no mighty men of valor. Nothing. Everybody
nothing to protect them.
Little common little Joe.
Happy little place.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? That might put them to shame in anything. So mm-hmm. in other words, whatever they did, nobody said not a word about it, not like today. Word. Well, if they want to be, let them mm-hmm. be. You ain't got to worry mm-hmm. about it. Don't say nothing. Just you be yourself, mind your own business. Blah, blah, blah. Nobody to put anybody to shame for whatever filth they were doing.
That's right. And I just want to say something, you know, like when those people be out there marching, you know, be for the gay rights and whatnot, you know, none of them out there. None of them out there with those signs can come and say that I am proud that my son just love big cocks.
Yeah, I am a proud mother of a son who likes to get a big cock up his butt.
Yeah.
What kind of pride is that?
They out there, but I'm telling you, they are embarrassed.
I say
I'm embarrassed.
Proud of my daughter because my daughter got good grades and she got a 4-year scholarship ride to a major league school. I'm proud of that.
I'm proud of my son. He's going to one of those fancy colleges, and he's going to be an engineer.
Or either my son decided he would go into the military if he wanted to do that, but he wants to do something. He doesn't want to just be nothing. But you are proud. I'm proud my woman plants her face between another woman's legs.
That could
what parent says that?
That could be funny. They're trying to perpetuate that filth because they are ashamed.
Very much ashamed.
Now let's keep
going. Here we go. And they were far from Judeans and had no business with any man. So this mm-hmm. meant they were secluded.
Yeah.
They didn't deal with no other people.
Nobody.
And they didn't have nobody to protect them. And they were far from a place where there were lots of people who could run in and mm-hmm. help them. Verse 8. And they came unto their brethren mm-hmm. to Zorah and Eshtaol. And their brethren said unto them, what say ye?
Mm-hmm.
Now, how things looking, right. y'all?
What's going on?
Yeah, what y'all think gonna do now?
Hey, what's
up? How can we handle this? Verse 9. And they said, arise, mm-hmm. that we may go up against them. For we have seen the land, and behold, it is very good. Mm-hmm. And are ye still? Be not slothful to go
uh-huh.
and to enter to possess the land.
That's right.
Let's hit it now. Uh-huh. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Let's go get it.
Verse 10. When ye go, ye shall come unto a people secure
uh-huh.
and to a large land.
Mm-hmm.
For God hath given it unto your hands.
Uh-huh.
A place wherein there is no want of anything that is in the earth.
All right.
Look what God mm-hmm. was preparing for the Danites.
Mm-hmm. See that? I mean, wherever God takes his people, they got more than enough.
More than enough.
See, we're in captivity now. We will never have enough. We will never have enough. But the day is coming when he's going to set us.
More than abundant.
And baby, we ain't gonna want for nothing.
That's
we
right.
ain't gonna want for nothing. Now let's keep on going.
Verse 11. And there went from this of the family of the Danites
uh-huh.
out of Zorah and out of Eshtaol mm-hmm. 600 men mm-hmm. appointed with weapons of war.
Now these are the Most High's children.
Mm-hmm.
These are his people. This is one of the 12 tribes.
One of the 12 tribes.
Tribe of Dan. Now let's keep on going.
Verse 12. And they went up and pitched in whatever.
Yeah.
In Judah.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore they called that place Manhattan unto this day.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, it is behind Kindekatahim or whatever that place
mm-hmm.
is. So in other words, it's behind this particular place.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Where they. But they're not right up on it. They're not real close to it because those people couldn't come in and help those other folks.
Right.
But this is the land they took.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 13. And they passed thence unto Mount Ephraim
uh-huh.
and came unto the house of Micah.
Mm-hmm.
So they're back at Micah, where
back
the priest was. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Verse 14. Then answered the five men that went to spy out the country of Laish, mm-hmm. and said unto their brethren, mm-hmm. do ye know that there is in these houses an Ephraim and a Tephraim? Tephraim. And a graven image, mm-hmm. and a molten image. Mm-hmm. Now therefore consider what ye have do. Mm-hmm. So in other words, the imagery that belonged to Israel that he had made, they had to take that. Mm-hmm. Y'all gonna find out what the Danites, what all the Danites took.
That's right.
Alright, come on down here.
Let's look at verse 15.
Verse 15. And they turned hitherward, mm-hmm. and came to the house of the young man, the Levite. Didn't we mm-hmm. tell y'all? Mm-hmm. Micah had a lot of property. Micah had houses mm-hmm. and all that plopped all mm-hmm. over there and stuff. And he stayed in his own little place.
Right.
All right. Even unto the house of Micah, mm-hmm. and saluted him.
That's right.
Verse 16. And the 600 men appointed with their weapons of war, which were of the children of Dan, stood by the entrance of the gate. All 600 of them. Mm-hmm. Check this out. Mm-hmm. And the five men that went to spy out the land went up and came in hither, mm-hmm. and took the graven images and the Ephraim and the Tephraim and the molten image, mm-hmm. and the priest stood in the entering of the gate with the 600 men that were appointed with weapons of war.
Standing with his
people.
See
what happens when family gets together.
Standing with his people.
This man done took him in. He gave him clothes, mm-hmm. and money and food, a place to live. Mm-hmm. But when it came to family,
that's right.
he stepped right out.
That's right.
And went with the Danites.
That's right.
Let's keep on going.
All right.
I'm on 18.
Mm-hmm.
And then these went into Micah's house, mm-hmm. and fetched the carved images and the Ephraim and the Tephraim, the Teraphim, mm-hmm. and the molten image, mm-hmm. and said the priest unto them, What do ye? Mm-hmm. Here's your question now.
Right,
we done come in here and we done mm-hmm. all this. Now it's your turn, priest.
And they said,
verse 19. And they said unto him, Hold thy peace.
All right.
Lay thy hand upon thy mouth. Uh-huh. Don't say nothing. Please, uh-huh. please, prophet, don't say anything.
Mm-hmm.
And go with us.
That's right.
And be to us a father and a priest.
Now, hold on a minute. See, because they wanted to stop the priest because they knew
if he said
whatever
anything,
came out of his mouth.
Whatever came out of his mouth, that's what it shall be. But
that's
listen to us first before you speak, priest.
That's
please
right.
listen to us.
Don't say
nothing. Begging him, pleading with their priest.
That's right.
Huh? He says, it is better for thee to be a priest unto the house of one man, or that thou be a priest unto a tribe of the family.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to stress this.
That's right.
The family.
Of who?
Not the nation. The family.
See that?
In Israel.
Right in the pages.
Huh?
Right in the pages.
You are one of the families of the father Israel.
One of the 12. That's
huh?
right.
And he said, here's one man that's giving you this little bit and taking care of you. What would happen if you come with your family?
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
That's right.
Verse 20.
Because you hold the blessings.
You keep the blessings.
You hold
we don't
the blessings.
Get them on our own. This is because of you.
Mm-hmm.
It says, and the priest's heart was glad.
See that?
Huh? My people.
Mm-hmm.
And he took the Ephraim and the Tephraim and the graven image and went in the midst of the people. Standing right
That's
there,
right.
Micah looking at every all mm-hmm. I done. Now you're going to take it and walk off in the midst of the people. Yes, that's what he does. Family.
Now he took Michael's God too.
Sure did. He took his graven images.
Sure did.
Sure took it all.
Took his gods.
All right. Mm. Now check this out. So they turned and departed. Turned from Michael's house. And put the little ones and the cattle in the carriages before them.
Look at that.
Huh? So y'all think that they took their little babies and put big cows in the carriages?
Not so.
Huh? They took them little
Not
white
so.
Fuckers and they set them up in there
That's
too
because right.
they was babies. They was
That's
little.
Right.
And they always took the little ones.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
That's
put them
right.
in the carriages with the children.
Mm-hmm.
Walked off.
That's
All
right.
Says 22. And when they were a good way far from the house of Micah, the men that were in the house near to Micah's house were gathered together and overtook the children of Dan. Mm-hmm. Now that was the five. Remember, there was five of them still there. The priest and the 600, mm-hmm. and took the cattle and the kids and everything, mm-hmm. and they left. Mm-hmm. All right, but them other ones were still there in the house. Mm-hmm. So these men saw what was going on. Whoa. What's going on? They came down there to see. Yo, do you see what just happened to Micah? Mm-hmm. With these people?
They come to help Micah. They done took his guards and everything.
All right.
Let's keep on.
Now, we're on 23. And they cried unto the children of Dan. Mm-hmm. And they turned their faces and said unto Micah, what lieth thee that thou comest with sure accompany?
What aileth thee?
Mm-hmm. And thou comest with sure accompany. Mean what was
with
going
such,
on?
Such a company.
Such a company. What's mm-hmm. going on? That all these 600 men and all mm-hmm. these. What happened here? You had a priest here and everything. Mm-hmm. Says 24. And he said, mm-hmm. ye have taken away my gods, mm-hmm. which I made, and the priest, and ye are gone away. And what have I more? Mm-hmm. And what is that? What is this that ye say unto me? What aileth thee? What do you mean? You done stripped me of everything I had.
What's aileth
me? You took everything. And then you gonna say, what's the matter with me? Yeah. Are you crazy? All right.
Let's keep on.
Verse 25. And the children of Dan said unto him, let not thy voice be heard among us.
All right.
Lest angry followers run upon thee, mm-hmm. and thou lose thy life. Yeah, in other words, we took every damn thing from you.
You better shut your mouth
or they'll come back and take your life.
That's right.
With the lives of thy household. Not just you, they'll kill everything.
Everything in there.
As y'all know, that's God's way.
That's right.
All right. We are his people.
Don't leave nothing alive.
Don't leave nothing
alive. Kill everything.
Verse 26, and the children of Dan went their way. Mm-hmm. And when Micah saw that they were too strong for him, mm-hmm. he turned and went back mm-hmm. into his house.
See that?
Can't do nothing with a Hebrew.
The Most High, when he's with you, you can't lose.
And he's with us. He ain't with us now. All this coming together shit. How you gonna come together? You don't know what tribe you're from.
Better sit down.
You don't all come together because you're black. You don't all come together because you from Levi and Judah and Dan and Issachar. You can't come together that way. That's not how God does things.
To my rising up, go out and get yourself killed.
Rise up, get yourself killed. We'll be sitting back here still teaching. Y'all be out there dead in the streets. 27.
Okay.
And they took the things which Micah had made, uh-huh. right? That we're at the right place.
That's right.
And the priests which he had, mm-hmm. and came unto Lasha, mm-hmm. unto a people that were a quiet and secure.
Uh-huh.
And they smote them. Uh-huh. Huh? The goody, goody, lovey, lovey, do what we want to do, people, huh? Yeah. They smote them with the edge of the sword, mm-hmm. and burnt the city with fire.
See, you reckon these people here have been talking to Jesus?
They probably have.
That's all he
love
talks
everybody
about.
And come that's together, all. Free love and all that, yeah.
But the Most High said, go on and take the shit. Take it.
He said, take them and burn all that shit up.
Take it. Take it. Well, what about the baby? Kill it.
Kill it.
Well, what about the real young baby, the one that's 3 days old? Strangle that one.
Y'all don't know the Most High God.
That's how the Most High is.
Definitely don't know his people.
That's how he is. And you know what? He gets enjoyment out of it, too.
He loves it.
It's like he's sitting in front of a television. You know,
he's watching the show.
That's his entertainment. I talked to you guys about that in one other teaching. But let's keep on.
Verse 28. And there was no deliverer.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Mm-hmm. Because it was far from Zidane, and they had no business with any man. That means mm-hmm. they didn't deal with nobody. They didn't mm-hmm. have nobody to come to their rescue. They was all alone. And it was in the valley that lieth by Bethrehood, and they built a city mm-hmm. and dwelt there.
They had them inheritance now.
Mm-hmm.
They got one now.
Took it all. Mm-hmm. 29. And they called the name of the city Dan.
Mm-hmm. But let me interject right there for a minute. Do you think that's the reason why they say all black people steal?
Of course. They know that God didn't have, we didn't ask nobody for shit. We just took it.
They know what the book said.
They know. That's why they're so hard on a thief.
That's why they say all blacks steal.
All blacks steal.
Because they knew that in the Old Testament, the black Hebrew Israelite,
he see something he won't, they go in and take it.
And they took it. They didn't ask for it. They took it.
They took it. God was with them.
Let's keep on.
29. And they called the name of that city Dan, mm-hmm. after the name of their father, who was born unto Israel.
Uh-huh.
All right.
See that?
Howbeit, the name of the city was Laish at the first,
mm-hmm.
and it got changed. And the children of Dan set up the graven images.
Now stop it there. Stop it there. Stop it there.
Ho! You ready to show y'all something?
Before you go any further, we need to address this right here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And the children of Dan.
The children of Dan.
Not the children of Israel.
Not the nation of Israel. The children of Dan.
Not the children of Israel, but the children of Dan. Can y'all, guys, see that there's a difference?
It's a big difference. Y'all can already see the difference.
Can y'all see that?
God get ready to show y'all.
Don't let anyone ever tell you again that the children of Israel is everybody.
It's not.
It's right in the pages.
The children are the Levites.
Right in the pages.
He get ready to show you in this verse right here, verse 30. What Dan did. Now y'all know Levi's commandments, don't
mm-hmm.
you? Y'all know what was told to teach the children of Israel.
That's right.
Okay, listen to this. And the children of Dan set up the graven image.
See that? See that?
Huh? And Jonathan, the son of Gisharam,
mm-hmm.
the son of Manasseh.
Now, if y'all don't get it the first time, go back and read it again.
Hmm?
Because if you read it long enough, you will get it.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's read that again.
All right.
Read it again, fool.
And Jonathan,
uh-huh.
the son of Gisharam,
uh-huh.
the son of Manasseh.
So that's two tribes there.
Huh?
Look what they're doing.
This is what they did. Now check this out. This is what they did. Mm-hmm. This was governing.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to show you Dan took somebody from another tribe
mm-hmm.
to be the police.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to show it to you. And he and his sons were priests to the tribe of Dan
mm-hmm.
unto the day of the captivity of the land.
See that?
Mm-hmm. Huh? So what they did was they assigned them to be the priest.
Mm-hmm.
And the Levite was with them. They already had the Levite there. The head priest was there because
mm-hmm.
they took him and he went with them.
Right.
But they had to have officers. Now they can already set up some law.
Mm-hmm.
So they went to Manasseh
mm-hmm.
and asked for some of his men
yep.
to be the police
mm-hmm.
to help out their priest in their land.
All right.
And they didn't get somebody that was of their own, because why? If your son did it,
that's right.
You don't tell on your son.
No.
Manasseh didn't give a shit.
Mm-hmm.
If your son did it, he gonna get you.
Yep.
So y'all see the difference in
Damn
how it. Things are done with the different tribes
mm-hmm.
pertaining to all the children, the children being of Levi
mm-hmm.
and how they were treated and how other tribes were treated.
Mm-hmm.
Let's finish this thing up in 31.
They do 31.
And they set them up Micah's graven image.
See that? See that?
His mm-hmm. God that he made.
Uh-huh.
Which he made.
Uh-huh.
All the time that the house of God
was in
shadow.
See that? See, in reality, Levi is the one that was given this law. Don't
Levi.
You have no other
they couldn't have it.
Graven images or nothing.
But the other ones built gods and everything else.
But the rest of them did it. It's right in the pages. Only the priest.
Only the priest.
The
and
Levites.
The reason why in Micah's house he had the Ephraim and the other thing was because he had a Levite priest.
That's
and
right.
The Levite priest could not pray to the God he made.
That's right, but he could pray
so
his God.
So he had to have something that represented
his God. And see, believe it or not, if you look at the writing, this man Micah knew that the Levite priest was the true and living God.
That's right. He was paying for him.
he knew that stuff that he had was bogus. I mean, that was number bunk. Mm-hmm. But when it came to the real deal, he said the words came. The words came out of his own mouth. Yeah. I know I'm blessed now.
I know I'm blessed now. I done made all these other gods, but I got me a real God now.
See, so my brothers and sisters, the real people of the Most High, they talk different.
Right.
They got a different message.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have the same message as everybody else is running with.
Yep. They just heard his voice.
Their voice is different.
He was a Levite.
Their voice is different. So my brothers and sisters, we will hope and wish that this teaching has been very enlightening to you. We hope that you really go back over this thing with a fine comb.
Read it.
And I ask you guys to read it and study and think about it. Mm-hmm. And I guarantee you, when you come out of it, you'll see things, man, I never saw like that before.
That's right. You're going to find out there's a big difference between Levi and everybody else. They are his chosen people. And mm-hmm. everybody wants a priest. Mm-hmm. Everybody.
Everybody.
God knew how important the priests were because
right.
God could be sitting on his throne just enjoying and relaxing, and the priest could be blessing people all over the town, all over the world if they wanted to.
And that's his chosen nation.
They're his people.
That is that great nation, Levi. Nobody else. Can no other tribe do what Levi does? Mm-hmm. None.
And Dan was, they were roaming around trying to find land. They were all together. Nobody was jumping up saying, I'm the leader. Mm-hmm. I'm the leader of the Danites. They saw a priest and jumped Dan on, and now we got someone to
mm-hmm.
lead us.
That's right.
All right. So we just want to thank you for tuning in tonight, family. And I pray that the Most High bring us some more about other tribes. I mean, mm-hmm. I don't know if he will or not, because this is about the priests, but it deals with the tribes, too. So at least mm-hmm. you did find out some things about Dan. So we hope you enjoyed this class tonight.
All right.
Until next time, Israel, shalom.